You have the Keto Camp and the Primal Camp and the Paleo Camp here, and then you have the High Carb Camp here, and there's really nothing in between. Well, I'm going to let you in on a little secret. You're always burning fat. Doesn't matter if you're doing a pasta feed the night before and just really following that high carb sports related diet that's full of carbohydrates, or you're doing full-blown keto, you're always going to be burning fat, metabolizing fat. You wouldn't be alive if you weren't metabolizing fat. And that's the point of optimized fat metabolism. You want to optimize your metabolism of fat, not just for energy, but for everything else. Hi there. Now, I'm kind of struggling here to kind of articulate what I want to do here today, but it really comes down to the fact that we humans in our conscious human thought tend to have this tendency to want to simplify things because our conscious minds can only handle so much. And that's led to a lot of what I call binary thought process, black and white, ones and zeros, yes or no, right and wrong. And it's no difference when we come to performance, and it's gotten to be kind of a lot of vitriol lately because you have the Keto Camp and the Primal Camp and the Paleo Camp here, and then you have the High Carb Camp here, and there's really nothing in between. Well, I'm going to let you in on a little secret. You're always burning fat. Doesn't matter if you're doing a pasta feed the night before and just really following that high carb sports related diet that's full of carbohydrates, or you're doing full-blown keto, you're always going to be burning fat, metabolizing fat. And so even the carb addict, the person who's burning a lot of carbs, they're burning a lot of fat because you wouldn't be alive if you weren't metabolizing fat. And that's the point of optimized fat metabolism. You want to optimize your metabolism of fat, not just for energy, but for everything else. The whole cholesterol situation is really a factor of not having optimal fat metabolism, because cholesterols are lipid-based. They're not carb-based. They are lipids, and you need to metabolize them. And when you have too much glucose, you impair your ability to metabolize cholesterol. You start to accumulate cholesterol, and you start to have problems. And that's kind of where we are. You are always burning fat, and people need to understand this. It's not a binary process. And so we want to optimize that. But likewise, for performance, when you go full keto, you're signaling to your body you're in a conservation state. And so that conservation state doesn't allow you to burn fat optimally either, because it's a conservation state. And this is why athletes feel that they have a governor on, that they don't have those extra gears they need to perform at their best. Is keto wonderful and healthy? Absolutely. Your body should be able to make ketones and even glucose from your liver. It should be able to burn more fat at much higher rates, because that's exactly how nature evolution shaped us to do. But is it optimal for performance and even health for the athlete? That's a big question. Again, ketosis, the study of ketosis, the body of literature up till recently has been done largely on sedentary and metabolically compromised individuals. What does that say about the performance individual? What I'm trying to lead to is, by talking to you about how even a carb burner burns fat, I want to kind of introduce you to a much more nuanced and shades of gray sort of way of looking at it, that it isn't a carb camp. It isn't a keto camp. It's a blend of both It's highly individualized, both for the individual and the sport they're doing, in order to achieve that performance and overall health objective. So I hope this may have been a little insightful. I hope it gets you thinking that it's not an either or, it's not this formula or that formula, that it's a more nuanced and blended thing that takes a lot more thinking and work. But in actual execution, it's really relatively simple. And that's why we do the heavy lifting in terms of going down those rabbit holes and figuring out those doable strategies that allow our athletes to get the superior levels of performance they're seeing. And most of all, by getting away from this blended thing, or this blended thought process that's promoted, we're getting back to you, the individual. And we want you to think, what's happened is these packaged, canned things that we're being bombarded with us has gotten us into this form of intellectual laziness, for lack of a better term. So, you know, we want to exercise that muscle called our brain. I'm going to call it a muscle because it needs to be exercised, it needs to be challenged, and it needs to get worked just as much as the rest of your body, so that you can find your journey to the health and performance that you deserve to have. Thanks very much.